Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm just gonna show you really quick and give you a quick review and walkthrough of the introductory guide to writing, to high school writing from Seven Sisters Homeschool. This is our first year using this and I am really enjoying it. I'm gonna tell you why in a second while I'm really enjoying going through this with my high schooler. So this is the introductory guide to high school writing. They have an introductory guide to high school writing, they have an intermediate one, and they have an advanced one. I decided to go with the beginner one. It says for kids starting ninth grade or kids that have not a lot of experience with writing. My daughter has experience with writing. My daughter does have a learning disability. She struggles with, you know, just putting paragraphs together and just getting her thoughts out on paper. So I decided this will be a really good, just a really good option for her. One of the things that I love about Seven Sisters Homeschool and all their products is that you can adapt it to work on your child based on their needs. So you can either do the basic part of it. If you have a child level one, level two, which is a kid that's not going to college, kid that might have a disability, that you're doing more remedial work, to all the way to advanced work if you have an honors kid. So so that's the reason I decided to do the introductory guide with her. So all the lessons, so this is introductory guide to high school writing. The first section have all the papers here are coming out that we're working on. So the first one is, when I bought this as a bundle, but you can buy it separate, I believe, but this is comes all together. It has essay writing, we have how to write high school poetry, introductory guide to APA research paper, and to short narrative story to writing a family narrative. So we started this for the second 6 weeks of school, like after our first 6 weeks, because we're kind of doing block scheduling. But we are right now working through our second paper. And I'm gonna say how much I love this. If you have a child like mine that struggles with school, that's very reluctant, that has anxiety and doesn't really like writing, doesn't really like schoolwork, this is perfect for them. Why? Because it takes them, when they're doing an assignment, so the first assignment they have to write about a hobby. So my daughter wrote about the volunteer work that she does at the farm. So we kind of changed it a little bit. It was not her hobby, it's kind of her work, but it's volunteer. But it takes you, and that is one of the things that I love about Seven Sisters Homeschool. You need to follow them on Facebook. They always say there's no one way to homeschool. So if you're going through an essay and you really don't like the topic you're talking about and you wanted to change it a little bit, go ahead and do that, okay? Don't worry about what's in the curriculum. That's what I love, 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 all their content. So go check them out, Seven Sisters Homeschool. They're amazing. And they're really good for high school, but just also high schooling kids with disabilities like mine. So we went, so one of the things that I like about this, it takes them step by step. So when we're doing the assignment for, the first one is that week one, we're going to be, or the first writing, we're going to be an essay format. Learn what the essay format is about and an introduction to essay writing. And they had to write about a hobby, which she wrote about, you know, volunteering at the farm. So the first day, the first week, what we went through this here tells you what kind of the format is, what the thesis is, what to have in your first paragraph, your two, third, fourth, and fifth paragraph, the, you know, conclusion. And it goes over it, and then at the end, it's asking them, write about your topic. What would you like your hobby to be about? It could just be a simple thing as writing my hobby or my favorite hobby is. That was it for lesson one. We went over how to write it, like what a thesis is, kind of that structure of an essay. It gives you a quick sample, and then write your thesis. What is your favorite hobby? And she wrote it down. That was it for week one, lesson one. For week two, lesson two, what we did, we had, okay, so we are going to get three reasons why this is your favorite hobby. Write the reasons down, then give me a little bit of, expand a little bit on each one. That was it for lesson two. Week three, it talked about what a grabber is, right? What you could write as a grabber. That's it for third week lesson. So I'm sorry, the fourth day. Then we go to week two. For week two, we are going to examples of how to write each body of the paragraph, how to add things to each paragraph. You know, so it gives you examples of what to do for each paragraph, and then each day, write paragraph two using an example of, you know, how to use an anecdote. The next day, let's write your other paragraph using a quote. The next one, writing, statistic. So each day, so week two, lesson two, do one body paragraph, one thing. The second one, second body paragraph, third body paragraph. Then we went and we wrote the conclusion. That was in a different day. So it takes them step by step. For a child like mine, this works so well because each day is not overwhelming. If you have a child, you know, you might have a child that might be able to do the advanced one. So because they like writing, they're doing well in the writing and they enjoy school. But if you have a child like mine, this in introductory guide to writing is perfect because it takes them step by step. And it tells you, okay, for, you know, the next one, so we wrote the conclusion. Let's go over, you know, the editing. And it has an editing sheet in the back that you can follow, they can read. I did this with her. She has a hard time going through editing on her own, so I did this with her. So once we did it, we reviewed it, she turned it in, and I gave her, you know, and I gave her a grade. There were three different types of rubrics here. This one rubric for more, there's one for this essay part. For kids that are starting out, they don't have a lot of experience, so I decided to grade her the first one with that rubric. It was very simple. And then next time, then they have an essay rubric, and then there's one for when they do their editorial. So I decided to use the simple one for her first paper, and her second paper, now she's grasping, because you're going to use the same skills you learned for the first one to work on your second paper. So I'm going to use the one. This one is a little bit more involved, a little bit more detailed. But she's doing really well. She likes that she can write about what she wants to write about. So the next one that we're working on right now is the second essay. It's a persuasive essay. And she is talking, she has a favorite YouTube channel, Sam and Colby. They do exploring things and things about ghosts and stuff. And she's talking about trying to persuade people that this is the best YouTube channel. So she's really enjoying that because she can write about what she wants to write about. Sometimes we have worked in other curriculums before, and it kind of gives you a lot of things that you need to do this and this and that and that and write about this and make sure you have this and make sure. It was way too much. It was overwhelming for her, but this is more open and kind of gives them more freedom to do what they want to do. She's writing about what she loves. She loves that YouTube channel, and she wants to persuade people, telling them why it's the best channel. She's doing a pretty good writing. You know, we are working now through the revision of it. So it goes step by step. Week one, I'm sorry, day one, let's do this. Day two, let's take this little paragraph, introduction. Day three, let's do the third body paragraph. Now that you know from the first lesson, the first essay, what to do for your body paragraph, let's work on that for the second one. Okay, so you keep working through it. The next one, the next essay is gonna be compare and contrast essay. Then we have, what's the next one? Literary analysis and timed essays. I don't know if I'll go through a timed essay with her. She's not college bound. I might try just for fun, but I don't know if it's something that, so, and that's the first part. Then we have introductory guide to writing poetry. Again, this is a little shorter packet, but it goes step by step on how to do all your writing. I'm looking forward to doing this one. I might skip around after and go and come to this one. So, okay. One of the things that they say here in Seven Sisters Homeschool, like you can start with whatever section you want. Maybe do at the beginning of the year, go more of the research when you know your kids are going to be more involved in other things. I don't have that much time for school. Maybe work on poetry might be a little bit easier. So you can do it however you want to. So I think after this two, I might do, you know, go into poetry and come back. So make sure we have time to do a little bit of everything. But I totally recommend this for your child. And in each one, I'm going to show you really quick. and I'll leave quick, leave you all alone here. But she's here, so for all the grade levels, 9, 10, 11, 12, there's different levels. And I have a video where I talked about the different levels of where your child could be for homeschooling, and I will post that. That I learned from the Seven Sisters Homeschool. So your kid might be in level 2 in 9th grade, so they give you a quick, just an idea of what they should do. So in 9th grade, they're in level 2. These are not college-bound kids. Read at least 15 books. 3 could be classics, 5 can be books of the Bible. If you are, you know, if you're a Christian and you want them to read the books of the Bible, 15 books. It could be books they listen to, it could be books that you read to them, books that they read alone. Write 4 short papers, 2 essays, 5, and a 5-page, you know, paper. So it kind of gives you, depending on where your level of your child is. If you have a child level 3, is they're you know, college bound, but they're kind of, you know, not your average. I don't want to say your average kid, but you know what I mean. And all the way to level 5, when you have an honors kid that reads tons of books, like is able to write a lot of papers. So this is a really good cheat sheet, especially if you have a level 2 kid. Don't expect your level 2 kid, not college bound, may have a learning disability, to be doing level 5 work. This is why I love Seven Sisters Homeschool, because you can adopt it for your child and they do the work for you. That's why I appreciate them so much. They do the work for you. So if you have a child that struggles like mine, anxiety, has trouble writing, this, do the introductory one. Maybe next year do the advanced, or keep working on the introductory one. There's no one way to homeschool. I learned from Seven Sisters. So yeah, so this is what is, like I showed you, very simple one. And so everything that they, I'm gonna mention, everything is downloadable. You don't get it when you buy from them, you don't get anything, you know, printed. You print it out yourself. So yeah, there's a lot of printing and you can do it from the computer, but I like to print things out for the most part. So yeah. So I really think this will be for your child that struggles, child that's struggling in school. I think this will be a great, great, great resource for them. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye.